Sagittarius, welcome back to the channel. Monica Louvre here at The Love Messages. So today we're going to be doing your reading from now until mid-November. Now this is going to be a general reading, so it may resonate with you, it may not. If it does resonate with you, there will be a link in the description box for the extended. Sagittarius, in this reading, I'm going to be taking a look at past, present, and future for you. I'm going to clarify the cards and pull some advice. Okay, so your challenge, Sagittarius, is the Two of Swords, and what you don't see coming at the bottom of the deck, you have the Fool upright. So Sagittarius, your biggest challenge here is the Two of Swords. We're gonna clarify the Two of Swords. We're gonna see why it's your challenge in a moment. Now, in the recent past, Sagittarius, you have the Five of Pentacles, you have the Ace of Pentacles, and you have the Eight of Pentacles. So in the recent past, it looks like there was a situation in your life. This has something to do with a job that you were working with, either a job or this could be a romantic situation. I'm going to tell you both stories. The first story here is that a lot of you may have chose to disconnect from a job position that you were in here in the past. Okay, you may have stopped working or you may have abandoned a job just all together in the past because there was a new opportunity or a bigger and better opportunity that came in. And this could also be romantic, okay? So some of you may have tried to work things out with someone here in the past. And as a result of trying to work things out here with someone in the past, this person may have left or you may have left. Someone here left in the past because there was a bigger or better opportunity. Okay, so this is what I'm seeing, but we're gonna clarify, we're gonna get more information for you in a moment. Now, in the present moment, you have the Queen of Swords, you have the Queen of Wands, and you have the Star. So it looks like for you in the present moment, there's something here about an air sign, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Some of you are either dating an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or you could be dating a fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. There's a lot of this talk in the present moment about the future, healing, working together in terms of some sort of vision here in the present moment. So we're going to talk more about that and see what you need to know in a moment. Okay, now in the near future for you, Sagittarius, you have the Knight of Cups, you have the Seven of Wands, and you have the Six of Cups. So in the near future, it looks like there's somebody coming in from your past. There's something here about someone from the past, maybe a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I do see you blocking this person, or I see you being too busy to even deal with this person is what I'm getting. I'm not sure why this is showing up in the near future. There could be some sort of unresolved issues here maybe with this person from the past. I don't know. We're going to see when we clarify. What you don't see coming at the bottom of the deck, you have the Fool, you have the King of Wands, you have the Three of Pentacles, the Moon, you have the Five of Swords and the Six of Swords. So a lot of you are choosing to disconnect or remove yourself from any drama, okay, over the next couple of days. And for many of you, there's a lot of uncertainty connected to a partnership or collaboration of sorts. I do see a new beginning that's coming in for you, and this new beginning has a lot to do with moving to the next level. But there's a lot of uncertainty connected to a partnership or a group project that you're doing. There could be a lot of drama, and as a result of that, you may decide to disconnect from this situation, okay? If this is about love, I do see you having some sort of new beginning, so you could be potentially meeting someone new here. I'm seeing you move forward. Some of you are going to be committing yourself, or there could be some sort of talks or discussions about committing yourself to someone if you are single. Okay, so let's get into your reading, Sagittarius. Let's do some clarification and let's see what's going on for you. Okay, let's clarify the Two of Swords. Okay, so your challenge is clarified by the Ten of Pentacles. You have the Seven of Swords and the Judgment. So your challenge has a lot to do with, I'm getting something here about a fear, like unresolved you know, issues or fear connected to trust. Okay. There's a challenge here that has a lot to do with this could be you or someone you're dealing with. Now, if this is someone you're dealing with, I get a strong energy here of this person being closed off to you. Okay. Being closed off to you for a couple of reasons. The first thing that I'm seeing here that's been really challenging is the trust. You know, the Seven of Swords has been a very strong card that's been coming out for a lot of people. Okay. Now, for you, there's definitely something here about coming to some sort of realization about not being able to trust people, being closed off, blocking people, not wanting to confront people, not wanting to deal with certain situations. And what this is actually doing is it's blocking your abundance, okay? So the more you assume that you can't trust everybody, the more you say to yourself, I can't trust this person, I can't trust them, I'm just gonna close myself off. Well, you're missing opportunities by doing that. And this is what a lot of people don't realize, right? A lot of people don't realize that, you know, you have tons of opportunities. Opportunities are there every single day. And people may say, well, you know, there's no opportunities. I don't know what you're talking about. Yeah, there is opportunities there, okay? It's about you being open to them. So if you are somebody who's blocking everybody, you're closing yourself off to everyone, nobody's good enough, everybody's a liar, cheater, stealer, well, then you're only blocking your own abundance. So this is about coming to a realization and recognizing the people that you can trust. And I often say that the best way to recognize the people that you can trust is look at their actions. What are they doing? How are they acting? Okay, because I can sit up here and be like blah, 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 all day. I can be like that. But it doesn't matter what I say. It matters about my actions. Okay, so it's the same thing when it comes to trusting people, when it comes to relationships, when it comes to just simply dealing with people in general. So this is what Spirit is saying to you. This is going to be a big part of your challenge because, you know, when the sun is transiting your 12th house in Scorpio, there's a lot of issues coming up from the past. There's a lot of these energies coming up of you reminiscing about the past or thinking about the past. And this is what's telling you or telling what you're telling yourself. You're saying, well, remember what happened back then? Remember this scenario and this situation? Why should I open myself up to the situation now? What, to get burned again? That's what you're saying to yourself. But what you don't realize is that you're saying no or you're closing yourself off to the wrong people. And the more you do this, the more opportunities pass you by or the more opportunities are not realized. Okay. And this is a big part of your challenge between now and mid-November, okay? So let's talk about the recent past, Sagittarius. Let's clarify the Ace of Pentacles in the recent past. So the Ace of Pentacles is clarified by the High Priestess. You have the Nine of Swords and you have the King of Wands. So in the recent past, I really do strongly feel that there was a new opportunity that presented itself to you. There was a lot of fear and worry about this new opportunity that came in. And even though you intuitively felt it was the right thing to do, a lot of you still worried about the situation because of maybe something here that happened in the past. Yes, and this is what I was picking up with your challenge, and there's that confirmation. The Six of Cups is a card of the past. So a lot of you, like I said, and I'm just going to say this again, there's tons of opportunities that present themselves to you, but because something here in the past happened very badly, it has created trauma. It's created some sort of PTSD, okay, post-traumatic stress disorder. And you've been carrying this with you for quite some time. And what this is actually doing is it's energetically blocking you from the abundance that you truly deserve. Okay. And to deal with this situation, I'm just going to tell you like it is, to deal with the situation, you know, getting counseling, talking to somebody that you trust is going to be super important because it's going to help you to really understand why you went through that. And this is what we all don't realize is that when we go through trauma, whatever trauma is, whether it's trauma from childhood or trauma from relationships or just trauma in general, okay, and there's different types of trauma, we need to be able to find somebody that we can trust to talk about that, okay, to really, even if we're talking to ourselves about it, whatever we need to do to make sense of why we went through that. And when we can truly make sense of why that happened, that's a form of working through it. And some of you may have done that here in the past because you said to yourself, I no longer want to be held back. I want to be able to realize my true potential here. Tell me more about the Eight of Pentacles in the recent past for Sagittarius. So the Eight of Pentacles is clarified by the Six of Cups, the Strength, and the Death. Yes. Some of you work through your issues, okay, here in the past, and you found the inner strength to get over this situation, to bring it to an end. So again, each of us are on different timelines. You started to bring light, or light started to shine on the situation, which needed to be worked through. So a lot of you worked through this situation and you were able to completely end it and move on to something else here. There was definitely a period of time where you were in hermit mode in the past. You were, you know, thinking about things that were, that affected you from the past. Tell me more about the Five of Pentacles in the recent past for Sagittarius. So the Five of Pentacles is clarified by the Ten of Swords, the Four of Wands, and the Ace of Pentacles. So even though something here came to an end, okay, some of you experienced abandonment. Some of you were maybe in a relationship, or you experienced some sort of childhood abandonment here in the past. And what this led to was a challenge for you to work through those past traumas. Now, like I said, some of you work through those past traumas, and guess what? You move forward and there was a new opportunity that came into your life. Some of you started a new relationship, or you moved in with somebody new here in the past. Okay. So again, each of you are on different timelines. Some of you work through your trauma, others of you didn't, and it created more stress and worry for you. And this is why your challenge is the Two of Swords, because until you deal with the trauma, until you stop assuming that everybody's bad and everybody's out to get you, and you start to open yourself up to opportunities. And again, like I said, if you haven't done the inner work, that needs to be done first, and then you can open yourself up. Okay. And that's going to be the process for you. And until you do that, this is going to be a big part of your challenge. Okay. Now let's talk about the present moment. Now in the present moment, let's clarify the Court cards. Let's clarify the Queen of Wands in the present moment. Okay, so the Queen of Wands is clarified by the King of Swords. You have the Two of Cups and the Temperance. So somebody here in the present moment likes you. They want to have a relationship with you. Things have been moving extremely slow between you and this person. Could be an air sign, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. The reason why things have moved very slow for you is either you're still in the process of healing and being able to even trust this person to open up to them, or you and this person still need to heal unresolved issues, and it's taking time for that to happen for some of you. Tell me more about the Queen of Swords in the present moment. What's the important message for Sagittarius? So the Queen of Swords is clarified by the Page of Pentacles. You have the Knight of Wands, and you have the Five of Swords. So in the present moment, it looks like, I'm just going to mention this. There's something here about a third party. And there is a lot of this power struggle energy in the present moment. Now, it looks like somebody you're dealing with could be a Taurus. They want to have a new beginning with you. Could also be a fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. So there's a lot of healing that still needs to take place because of this trauma that happened. And I feel like the trauma has a lot to do with the past, and it's seeping into the present moment. But it's also connecting to, it's also connecting things to the future as well too, right, that you have to be aware of. One of the things that's taking place right now, and I did say this for Cancer, so some of you could be dealing with a Cancer, or you could be a sun, moon, or rising Cancer dealing with a Sagittarius. What's coming to an end is difficulties, okay? And this is happening for many of us because Saturn has just recently gone direct. It's gone direct in Pisces on the first degree, which means that there's a new cycle coming in after a major cycle that's been happening for quite some time. So if there's been third party for quite some time, that's coming to an end, or it's going to be rectified here and things are going to be healed between you and this person. I am getting the Emperor as well in the present moment. So now that a cycle that's been very difficult for you is closing out, stability is starting to come into your life, right? And you haven't seen stability for quite some time, but now it's coming in for you is what Spirit is saying. And it's important that you're healing your relationship. Certain relationships around you need to be healed. Okay. So I feel for many of you, need to unplug something there. Sorry about that. Some of you are unplugging from someone, or you're unplugging from certain situations. And I feel like I'm just going to tell you the story in the present moment from a different perspective, and give a little bit of context to the situation. So in the present moment, some of you still have unresolved issues with certain people. Okay. This could also be the case as well in the present moment. So you have this person to deal with that. You have like a bunch of different people that you have to deal with individually. And it's very important that you're closing things out with each of these people correctly and you're not leaving any loose ends, okay? Because again, a lot of you have trust issues because of these relationships that you've been engaging in. Some of you have been engaging with certain people that are not on your level, and you know, this is what's creating the drama, okay, in the present moment. So just remember, in the present moment, good news here is that when you are ready to heal yourself within yourself and you're ready to close things out with the people around you correctly, that is what's going to allow you to have this new beginning. And this is what you don't see coming, right? The ace, the fool, and the King of Wands, which is you. So this is you having a brand new beginning. You're finally having a brand new beginning, but you also need to recognize who you are collaborating with, who are you cooperating with, right? Because a lot of you are still confused about these relationships that are in your life, and it's very hard to trust these people that you're dealing with, okay? And this is what's happening in the present moment. Now, let's talk about the near future. Now, in the near future, there's something here about the past that's showing up, so I'm gonna immediately go there and clarify the Six of Cups. Let's clarify the Six of Cups. So the Six of Cups is clarified by the Eight of Swords. You have the Queen of Pentacles and you have the Three of Pentacles. So in the near future, I really do strongly feel there is going to be some sort of offer from someone from your past, an earth sign, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. I'm also getting an Aquarius here, maybe a Cancer, Sun, Moon, or Rising. Now, I'm just going to put this out there. If you have unresolved issues with a specific person that you cannot trust, there will be an opportunity to resolve these issues. And I did mention this to Capricorn, so you could be someone who has a rising Capricorn or a moon Capricorn here. Some of you have unresolved issues with a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. It looks like they are also going to be coming around here. Or if you're dating this person, a lot of you may end up disconnecting or walking away from this water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, because this person's not consistent with you, or they haven't been consistent with you, and you start to see the truth from this person based on their actions. So there could be something here that this person's doing that you don't like, and it comes to light for you. And because the sun is in your 12th house, it means that you're more psychic, you're more aware of stuff when the sun is in the 12th house. You're more introverted and going inner. So I see you creating boundaries. You're setting boundaries with certain people from your past. You're setting boundaries with certain people that you're dealing with presently. And you're seeing somebody's character for what it is, okay? It's like you see somebody for what it is. And this is what's creating the blockage for you, because you've had such bad experiences with certain people that you're assuming everybody else is like that. And this is about you recognizing in the near future who is for you and who's not for you. Who do you need to walk away from? Who do you need to disconnect from? Who is not giving you what you need? Who does not have similar views or values to you? And this is why you're creating boundaries, because you're tired. You're tired of dealing with people that you cannot trust. And this is how you're going to be able to move forward, by recognizing who is for you and who is not for you. It's a big, big thing. And I did mention this in some other previous reading for you. It's just coming more to light now as we enter into your birthday season, which is happening in a few weeks, okay? So let's clarify the Seven of Wands in the near future. What does Sagittarius need to know? So the Seven of Wands is clarified by the Three of Swords. You have the Ace of Wands and you have the Four of Cups. So in the near future, I really strongly feel there is going to be a new beginning, but the new beginning that presents itself, you may not be interested in it because you still have not worked on your challenge, which is the blocked energy. A lot of you are going to comment and say, yeah, I do need to keep myself blocked from certain people because I'm always hurt. But you're not always going to be hurt in those situations. There's going to be situations where you need to identify people by knowing who's the right person and who's not the right person. That means not rushing into, you know, being with the wrong people. That means taking your time to get to know somebody here. So even though a new beginning's showing up, even though there's an opportunity for it, I don't think you're quite ready for it in the near future because you're still in this process of healing. And also, I just want to mention this to you as well, Sagittarius, if you're dealing with people in your life that you really don't want to deal with them, but you're dealing with them just because you have to, it's really important that you're honest with these people. And I don't think you have a problem being honest. honest with them and telling them what you expect, okay, and what you want. So this is going to be a very, very, very important thing that you're learning and you're knowing here, okay, when it comes to having some sort of new beginning. And for many of you watching this, the reading is going to sound complicated, but it's only going to make sense for those of you who need it. So if it's not your reading and it doesn't make sense at all, then it's just simply not your reading, okay? So let's get some advice for you. Not everybody is bad, okay? There's certain people that are good out there, but finding those good people takes time and it takes effort and it takes research, right? Your biggest piece of advice here is to really ask yourself, and this is how you're gonna know if someone's for you or not. If there's a conflict and you and this person are not on the same page, which is what's happening for many of you right now, you are being confronted with some form of a conflict, dealing with certain people. And what Spirit is saying is that if you're going through this and you're realizing or coming to some sort of conclusion about a certain person or situation, the reason why you and this person are having a conflict is because it's trying to get your attention. It's trying to get your attention about money or some sort of long-term commitment that you're in. There's a conflict happening about money, and the best way to resolve the situation to move on from this is going through this lesson, okay? And the lesson here is that always talk to the person thoroughly. Talk to whoever you're dealing with, whether it's business or what, you know, if it's personal, relationship, whatever, it doesn't matter if it's personal or not. You and this person need to be on the same page. And this is something that I've been repeating over and over again on the channel, because we just had the solar eclipse in Libra, and the solar eclipse in Libra is an emphasis. It's emphasizing the balance we need in our relationships. And a lot of relationships that are not meant to be are, it's gonna come to the surface now and it's gonna show us. It's gonna say, oh, well, this relationship's not for you. Oh, this relationship's for you. So this is about sifting the relationships that are not meant for you out and bringing forth the relationships that are for you. And it's not gonna come without conflict. I'm gonna tell you that right now. It's not gonna come without conflict, because the conflict is an indicator that it's not for you. That's what we don't realize, right? We think, oh, I don't wanna fight, I don't wanna argue, I don't wanna get mad. Well, there's a reason why the conflict's happening. It's happening to show you that you and this person are not on the same page. And it's better to realize that you and this person are not on the same page. Why? Because it saves time and money, okay? So this is gonna be a big part of your reading and your advice, okay? So Sagittarius, I hope you got something from the reading. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.